everybody. Happy 2022. We made it. Woohoo! Are you ready for a New Year's resolution revolution? Well, I am. And I'm here to help guide you through a quick neurosculpting session to help make sure that your New Year's resolutions will actually stick this time. And I know this from personal experience because after years and years of doing New Year's resolutions and having them not work out, the last several years, my New Year's resolutions have happened. I've been able to achieve them, and that's because I found a wonderful tool called Neurosculpting from the Neurosculpting Institute in Denver. And basically, it combines the best practices of neuroscience and what they find out about neuroplasticity and how to rewire your brain, combined with ancient meditation and visualization techniques. And I got an airplane going overhead because I'm outside in beautiful Central California at the beach, in case you can't tell. So, hey there, fly boys and girls. Okay. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to give you a little bit of an overview of what neurosculpting is so that you know what to expect. I'm going to tell you what the five steps are, and then I'm going to lead you in a neurosculpting session that you can use 1 to 3 times a week. And more importantly, during that, you create a little phrase or word and a physical, it's called a somatic cue, that you use throughout the day that literally rewires your neural network in your brain so that you are creating new neural pathways with your new habit and overriding your old habit. And I don't care how many weeks, months, decades, years that you've had your old habits, you can literally rewire them. So it's just like a rut in a road. You know, you're gonna go into it if you don't have something better. This can actually cut off old neural networks and give you new ones. So let's get started. So there's a 5-step process in neurosculpting, and let me tell you what that is. The first is we start with centering and calming. So I'm gonna calm your limbic system and downregulate your limbic system. That means you get centered. The part of us that goes into fight, flight, freeze, or fawn mode, we just wanna calm that down so that any agitation, even good excitement, like I gave you a little good excitement at the beginning of this. It's called eustress, E-U-S-T-R-E-S-S, eustress. It's a good form of stress, you know, it's happy stress, but it's still exciting and we want to calm down. And then the second step is to activate your prefrontal cortex. That's right behind here. This is our higher self, our wisdom self, our big picture self, our empathic abilities and our ability to care about others and make the right decisions long term. That's the second step. We activate that. And we do that through curiosity. So your limbic system wants safety and security. Your prefrontal cortex wants novelty. Every human on the planet, every mammal needs a combination of both. And different humans have a different mix. An accountant or a very conservative individual is kind of risk averse, might want 98% security and 2% novelty. A freewheeling artist, you know, actor, somebody who, you know, lives on the road and whatever, might be more like 60% security and 40% novelty. There's no right answer, except there is a right answer for you. You've got your own combination that makes you feel good. So we're gonna activate both parts of you so you can balance and have this novelty pique your curiosity. And then we're going to do 3 steps that are going to ensure that you are rewiring your brain with the new habits you want and overriding your old tapes, your old stories, your old beliefs, your old habits that are holding you back, okay? So those steps are going to be toggling the left and right brain. This is really like balancing. You know, if you go to the gym, you're not just working out your right arm or your left arm or your right leg or your left leg, you're balancing. And just like when you're cycling or doing solo weights, you're doing your right and then your left, your right and then your left. We're gonna do that with your left and right lobes, front and back. And we do that because your left brain likes things that are very concrete, very known entities. That's the engineer in us all that, you know, that wants ones and zeros, black and white, things very clear and cut and dried. Okay, then our right brains, which is our creative side, that's the one that likes things mostly half, you know, likes, it's fine with fractions, fine with ambiguity, prefers it, would rather think in color and texture than in numbers. It prefers language and flowery words, poetry, as opposed to math, okay? And we, as human beings, are all of that. And we have a masculine energy side and a feminine energy side. Every individual, doesn't matter what gender you are. So this is about balancing that. And by balancing your front and back, left and right, and toggling back and forth, you are priming your brain. You're waking up your brain. Because you can't get a new habit really strongly unless you have an emotion with it. You have to have emotion. So here's a story that is very true. You know, let's say you're a young child and you come into the kitchen one morning and grandma is making hot chocolate chip cookies, and that smell of sugar and butter and vanilla, and then grandma's giving you a big hug, and here you are, a little kid who could, you know, is loving that love and acceptance at a time when maybe you just started kindergarten, maybe you're feeling nervous with all the new kids, whatever it is, you're getting all this love, and that the powerfulness of the senses of your nose smelling these scents and getting and feeling the hugs at the same time are literally wiring your brain to equate chocolate chip cookies and those wonderful scents with love and acceptance. And we have good memories and bad memories, all hardwired this way. Every one of us does. So, you know, maybe somebody had something traumatic happen to them with chocolate chip cookies, and so that is a scent that brings up trauma for them and anxiety. That's how we're wired. And the reason is because of something in neuroscience called Hebb's rule, which is that it's the axiom that that neurons that fire together wire together. So when you have a strong emotional response with a strong physical response, they get hardwired, and it accelerates the wiring of that memory, and it becomes this like bestseller. It becomes your top Netflix movie. It's the hit, and it's a classic, and it doesn't go away, and it's always there. And so what we want to do is leverage all of that greatness of your brain to help you with your goals. So let's say you want to lose 10 pounds. And by the way, I've lost over 20 pounds in the last 2 years from doing neurosculpting around this, and I'm doing another 10 right now. So what we're gonna do is, let's say you want to lose 10 pounds. Obviously the memory of chocolate chip cookies isn't gonna help with that, but it's hard to get excited about kale and arugula salad, you know, or going out in, you know, before dawn in cold weather, you know, to do your jogging. So what we do is we associate the feeling of what it is we're achieving with our goals. So if your thing is, let's just say it's to lose weight, maybe that's because you want to feel healthier and you want to feel vitality, or you want to feel younger, or maybe you're single and ready to date and you're like, hey, I want to feel sexier, and whatever it is, the reason why you have the goal is where your emotion lies. And we're going to tap that, we're going to tie that emotion, we're going to get that fired up so you see it, feel it, you're going to smell what it's like to feel 10 pounds lighter, and hopefully that's more like perfume or cologne than sweaty gym clothes. But you know, you're gonna feel it with all your senses, and you're gonna attach that to the neurosculpting that we're gonna do. So you're gonna hardwire that feeling in, and then you're gonna reinforce it every day. So the third step is gonna be the toggling, and then the fourth step is gonna be taking your visualization of the success of your goal and tying it to we're gonna tie it to a somatic cue, which means either like tapping like this or tapping like this. You can tap your arm. Some people like to do this. I personally like to do this because I speak on stage a lot, and I like to be able to put my hand down even behind me, and I can tap and remember my cue, and it resets, it calms me down, it does all this. So that's what we want to do. So you're going to have a somatic cue. You can either do this kind of tapping, and you do it with your non-dominant hand. So I'm doing it with my left hand because I'm right-handed. So if you're a lefty, you want to do it with your right hand, because that's going to, your your dominant side of your brain is so used to doing things that it's not going to wake up. It's kind of like, yeah, whatever, I can do this in my sleep. So you've got to wake yourself up, and that's what we're going to do. Okay, so now we're going to go into the meditation, and I'm going to put that as a separate link here so that you can download it, and you can use it 1 to 3 times a week. It's my gift to you. Happy 2022. And I'll give you some directions at the end of that of how to reinforce it. You're going to reinforce it with your non-dominant hand by like stirring your coffee or tea in the morning with your non-dominant hand and repeating that phrase. So that phrase could be, you know, it could be sexy. It could be, you know, younger, young, you know, vitality. It can be, you know, badass, crushing it, you know, beautiful and bodacious, whatever your phrase or word is that you want to use. And the great thing is whenever you say it, think it, or read it, and you do your tapping, you're rewiring your brain in overtime. So you're going to have an amazing accelerant on your habit setting. And this is why this year's resolutions are a revolution, because it's not like it was before. You're not just going to fall off. You're going to make it happen. So happy 2022, everybody, and let's go over to our meditation.